The students and faculty of the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering are making discoveries that will make a positive impact on the quality of life for millions of people. The department focuses on safe structures, water, and transportation, all of which are critically important to local communities and to our country. This is why students love the challenges in this profession.
My name is Inna Tasmaly, and I'm in the Civil Engineering Department with a focus on structural engineering. Structural engineering to me is the technical aspect of designing a structure. So I picked this field because I was interested in architecture and buildings. I found structural engineering from that. You actually see the math applied into the real world and the real environment.
My name is Zach Pesicka. I'm a civil engineering student. I'm a senior this year. I started out wanting to do drafting, which is basically what an engineer designs and then they give it to a drafter who draws it. I decided that I'd rather be doing the design than just drawing it up. Civil engineering allowed me to be more creative and to help people out by designing things that are going to help them. I guess a lot of times people picture structural engineers as being kind of the guy with the pen protector in his pocket and he just kind of is sitting in an office crunching numbers, but that's really not what structural engineering is. Structural engineering is more of you have to talk to the architect, you have to talk to the owner, you have to talk to the contractor. You have to make sure that the design is being built the way it was designed so that it works.
I'm Aaron Knight and I'm in the Civil Engineering Department. Every system that is inside of a building is touched somehow by civil engineers. And you get to combine not only your interests in math and science, but with real world applications that, you know, you can work on a project and then you can take your family, you can take your kids, you can take your grandkids back there someday and you can show them, hey, this is what I worked on. I first started getting interested in transportation when I started driving. You see stoplights and you see roads and you see signs and it seems like there's an order to them, but you know, what is it? I would look around and I would see different things and be like, oh man, they should have done it this way because it'd be a lot more efficient. Or I would say it would, you know, make my commute a lot faster if they only did it this way. When you work on projects, you see the result pretty quick and a lot of people notice the result of what you did because, you know, for better or for worse, simply retiming a traffic signal can save people, you know, 15 minutes in their commute. That's pretty cool.
You get to do a lot of hands-on things. We have, you know, the concrete lab where you can test cylinders, you build your own concrete, you use your own hands. Concrete is a major building material and it's used in every structure that you see, either as the foundation or even as the main superstructure. It's used in highway design. It's used for bridges, for just for roadways. So concrete's very important and we want to know how it behaves. And so we test it under compression. We use a machine that compresses the concrete and squishes it and until it breaks, and then we know its strength. And then we also have machines that pull it apart.
Idea of design right now, you design for collapse. So you design to make sure that the building does not collapse no matter what the earthquake is.
So this is what we're standing in here. This is a braced frame. It's a singly braced frame, diagonally braced, and we're loading it from over here. This is called an actuator. The actuator pushes it this way and then pulls it back this way to load it, and it simulates an earthquake loading. So what that does is that puts a lot of strain on this brace right here. And you can see what happened to the brace. As you push and pull on the frame, the brace gets pushed and pulled on, and then it finally buckles. And this is called buckling, and then we actually measure the strains, and then we can decide how well the brace performed.
One of the great things is that when you graduate with your degree in civil engineering is you're not locked into only doing one thing. You have a very broad degree where, you know, you can be flexible once you get into the workplace. You can choose to design houses or you can design skyscrapers. You can design, you know, dirt works, you can design dams, you can design bridges. Everything a civil engineer has their hands in.
I wasn't sure whether I wanted to do structural geotechnical engineering within the civil engineering field, and after that internship I was able to realize that I would prefer the structural aspect versus the geotechnical, but it also gave me a vastly larger understanding of how foundations work.
I interned for 3 summers total. I actually got to do things that I'm going to do as an engineer once I graduate. I started out at a private company. There I did a lot of drafting. I did some project management. I also interned for the Corps of Engineers, and we went out to the Howard Hanson Dam and we got to look at some of the damage and things like that that they were trying to fix. I also worked at Fort Lewis and did a lot of looking at building repairs, looking at a wastewater treatment plant and what kind of repairs needed to happen there.
It's a stressful field, but it's very rewarding as well. You know, so if you like to like to help people out, it's definitely a field to go into.
It's a lot of applied science and math, and that's why the engineering school is a good choice.